प्रणवधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषा वहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। यः पूर्वं तपसो जातम् अद्भ्यः पूर्वमजायत गुहां प्रविश्यति स्थन्तम् यो भूतेभिर्व्यपश्यत एतद्वैतत् यः पूर्वं तपसो जातम् अद्भ्यः पूर्वमजायत गुहां प्रविश्यति स्थन्तम् यो भूतेभिर्व्यपश्यत एतद्वैतत् स्वावतारिका यहा प्रत्यगात्मेश्वर भावेन निर्दिष्टः स सर्वात्मा इत्येतत् दर्शयति। सो इन द अर्लियर मंत्र वी हैव सीन दैट द प्रत्यगात्मा द आत्मा विच इज अटेनिंग विच इज उपलभ्यम इन दिस उपाधि ऑफ द जीवा जीव शब्द वाज यूज्ड देयर सो प्राण कलापक्ष धारयिता दट आत्मा इज शुद्ध चैतन्यम एंड ओनली विथ रेफरेंस टू दि बाह्य विथ रेफरेंस टू दि उपाधि इट इज कॉल्ड जीवा विथ रेफरेंस टू उपाधि इट इज कॉल्ड भोक्ता सो अदरवाइज इट इज असंग चैतन्य मिलोन दिस एस्पेक्ट इज ऑफ टू नाउ दट प्रत्येगात्मा समबडी मे थिंक इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द समस्त हिरण्य गर्भात्मा हिरण्यगर्भ उपाधिक आत्मा सो इट इज समथिंग लाइक द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी विच इज इन द हाउस विच इज 220 वोल्ट्स एंड 5 एम्पीयर्स फायर इट इज समथिंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी विच इज इन द पावर हाउस विच इज कमिंग विच इज रियली मेकिंग एवरी हाउस ग्लो विथ बल्ब्स एंड ऑल दैट पावर हाउस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी विच इज 10 मेगावाट्स वोल्टेज एंड अ वेरी हाई वोल्टेज एक्सेट्रा with a few hundreds of amperes of current flows in that. So that type of electricity and this electricity. So that is the samashti electricity and this is the yes electricity. So from our point of view both are because the voltage, the wattage, the amperage, all these parameters which define the electricity in terms of an upadhi, so they are different. There they are different, here they are different. Therefore we would like to think that they are different. So, but a person who knows the tattvam of the electricity, which is nothing but the movement of a few electrons through a wire, it is an electron moving is electricity, a charge moving is electricity. So, this tattvam is known for the fellow who has known the basic physics. For him, all the upadhi bhedas are there, the functional bhedas are there, but vastu bheda is not there, tattva bheda is not there. This is where the Hiranyagarbha Upadhi or the Hiranyagarbha Atma and the Jiva Atma are from the basis of Upadhi they are different. Different means what? Some difference you can always explain. But basically this Upadhi is made up of Panchabhutas. Virad Upadhi is also made up of Panchabhutas. This is a Purush Jiva Shuddha Vachya. He is also Jiva Shuddha Vachya. Except the some basic differences in the size, otherwise in that aspect also there are no differences. Deha also there are no differences. We say we go along with it, chalo, deha differences are there, yet Atma is not different. We emphasize on that. But if you carefully see, what is the difference in deham? Deham also from one deham to the other deham, what is the difference? The only difference is rupam is the difference and color is the difference. Otherwise really the masala which makes the body, that is not different. So similarly for Hiranyagarbha, that is not different. And the chaitanyam which makes the fellow as the enjoyer of rupa, rasa, gandha, etc., which makes the fellow see the entire world as a drushyam for him, that chaitanyam aspect is common for both. They are not different in both. Therefore, the jiva, the chaitanyam which is called jiva with reference to a given upadhi, a mithyabhuta upadhi, is called Hiranyagarbha with different Mithyabhuta Upadhi. If you negate the Upadhi, it becomes one and the same. Therefore, Vyashti Atma, the so-called Vyashti Atma, is really not different from
samasti atma. It is like the akasha in the house is different from the mahakasha. You may say so, but really the akasha is in the house is the same as mahakasha. So this ghatakasha, mahakasha eva. How ghatakasha can become mahakasha? The mahatvam of ghatakasha, the ghatatvam of this akasha are upadhi. The bigness and this ghatatvam, they are the upadhi. The moment you negate them, then akasha is one and the same. If there is a samshlesha for the akasha, if there is a real association which changes the nature of the akasha, then you cannot negate the upadhi. You have put water in two different parts. One part is having some dirt, another part is having clean, it is clean. Then you cannot say both waters are the same, because the water gets associated with the malinyam. There is atma and akasha, they are asanga, and therefore the upadhi, it is as though they are in the upadhi is not going to make any changes in the swarupam of the atma, which is asanga, and therefore nothing prevents us to the conclusion, to reach the conclusion, that the Hiranyagarbha Atma and the Jiva Atma is one and the same. That's why it is possible to do that laya prakriya in which you become the Hiranyagarbha. That's why Hiranyagarbha Upasana is possible. And that's why in various Upanishads, you become the Hiranyagarbha. By just, you are become the Samasti Atma, by just coming above the Vyashti Dharma. I am this body, that is a Vyashti Dharma. To come above that by jnanam, then you become one with the Hiranyagarbha. This is the prathama spadaha of the Mandukya Upanishad. There is Chetuspada. This is the first step. It's a big step. Somebody said it's a giant step. Like a big bhutam puts a step, it's a very big step, something like the just step to this. So the jiva in one step, he becomes the Hiranyagarbha. So that is presented here in this mantram. यहा प्रत्यगात्मेश्वर भावेन निर्दिष्टः प्रत्यगात्मा इज ईश्वर ईशानो भूत भव्यस्य अवित्रिफरेंस टू दिस उपाधि सो दैट इज हाउ इट इज प्रेजेंटेड जीवः इति सः इन रियालिटी सर्वात्मा इति इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सर्वात्मा दिस सत्यम इज शोन बाय दिस मंत्रम यहा तपसः पूर्वम अध्यः पूर्वम अध्यः पूर्वम तपसो जातम He is the Hiranyagarbha who is born from the waters. Adhyaha means the waters represent Panchabhutas. Water is not yet born means the Panchabhutas are not yet born. That means from the Mahatattvam, Hiranyagarbha is born. So tapa alochane, Bhagavan has got this sankalpa shakti by which the Mahatattvam is born from the avyakta, and that Mahatattvam is the Hiranyagarbha, buddhi samashti buddhyatmaka. So that is not at born, that is born. From it, the other srishti has not at born. So adhyaha purvam ajayata, tapasaha ajayata, and that virat sharira, the virat deham is there. In that virat deham, he has entered in the form of chaitanyam, and he is observing the entire deham of his own, which is the universe, with the help of these bhutas, so yapashyata. That he appears to be different from everything else. He also appears to be different from Atma entirely with reference to the Upadhi. But in reality, the Upadhi is negated. He is one and the same as the Atma which we are talking about, which Nishketa has asked for. So in terms of the Sarvatma Bhava, the Sarvatmatvam, this is present. That is the mantra. Bhashyakara makes it more clear. Yah kashchin mumukshuhu पूर्वं प्रथमं तपसः ज्ञानादिलक्षणात् ब्रह्मणः इत्येतज्ज्ञातमुत्पन्नम् हिरण्यगर्भम् सो यहा व्यपश्यत दट इज हाउ दि संबंधम यहा व्यपश्यत मीन्स हूसोएवर हैव सीन और The past tense has no relevance. Veda past tense is all converted to present tense. So whosoever sees, that means it can be construed as an upasana and also it can be construed as knowledge. So it is the truth. One has to see this truth. What is the truth? Yaha vyapashyata means yaha pashyati. who is that yaha kashchin mumukshuh. We talked about kashchit dhiraha amrutatvam ichchan, so that kashchit only, any sadhaka or any mumukshu, he sees this. What is it that he sees? For he sees this truth about the Hiranyagarbha, that is the connection. So that yaha is not Hiranyagarbha, yaha is the person who understands this truth about Hiranyagarbha. So what is the truth to be known about Hiranyagarbha? Purvam jataha, the Hiranyagarbha is born in the first fellow. So prathamajaha he is, jyeshtaha, purvam jatam, prathamam jatam, he is born first. How he is born? Tapasaha jatam. So jnanadilakshanat tapasaha jatam. So tapyata. So Parameshwara, he has made a sankalpa. That is the tapas. That is the jnanam is the sankalpam, which is the tapas. So from that sankalpa, this Hiranyagarbha is born from avyakta. He is born from the sankalpa of whom? Brahmanaha sankalpa jataha. So Parameshwarasya sankalpat, Shuddha Chaitanya Parameshwarasya sankalpat, tasya Parameshwarasya maya shiktehe avyaktat jataha. So that is how Hiranyagarbha is born. That jatam utpannam Hiranyagarbham. So that Hiranyagarbham pashyati. He sees. The sadhaka sees the Hiranyagarbha in this fashion. How? Kimapekshya purvamityaha. Abhyah purvam apsahite bhyah panchabhute bhyaha na kevala bhyod bhyaha ityavhiprayata ajayata utpannaha. He is born first, purvam, pratham. First he is born. First means what? There must be a second, then only the word first has meaning. So before whom he is born? From the Parameshwara. Kim apeksya purvam. There must be a next thing which is born later. So with reference to that, he is the prathamaja. So what is that next thing? Kim apeksya purvam ityaha. So that question is answered by the Shruti. Adhyav purvam. Panchami Bahuvachanam. With reference to upper, he is born first. Adhyav purvam. Up means it is one of the panchabhutas. So we should not think that first Hiranyagarbha is born, then up is born, and then other bhutas are born. No, not like that. Apsahitebhyaha, panchabhutebhyaha. So, up is an upalakshanam. So, including up, all the five bhutas are born later to him. Therefore, he becomes earlier to all the five bhutas. So, na kevalabhyaha, adhyaha, ityasitrayaha. We should not be under the impression that abhyaha means only water. Depending upon the context, he is born earlier to water means he is born earlier to panchabhutas. That is the idea. Ajayata pannaha. Yaha tam prathamajam devadi shariranyutpadya sarva prani guham hrudayakasham pravishya tishthantam shabdadi nupalabhamanam भूतेभिः भूतैः कार्यकारणलक्षणैः सह तिष्ठन्तम्. सो दिस डिस्क्रिप्शन एग्जैक्टली कोइंसाइड्स विथ दि ब्रह्मविद्या ब्राह्मणम ऑफ दि बृहदारण्यक उपनिषद. देयर द मृत्यु इज द नेम गिवन टू हिरण्यगर्भ. दट हिरण्यगर्भ इज द प्रथमजः. It is like Parameshwara has created Chaturmukha Brahma and asked him to do Srushti. That way of Purana presence, Veda presence in this fashion. He is the Prathamaja. From that Maya Shakti he is born, first person to take birth, first Jiva. So Parameshwara's Sankalpa was there, so he is born. Now he decided, though he is born as a Jiva, as a Karma Phalam he is born. He has done a Mahapunya Karma like Ashwamedha. Therefore, because of that karma phalam, he now became Hiranyagarbha. Having become Hiranyagarbha, he is still away from moksha. He has to know the truth of himself, then he gains moksha. He gains it eventually. So, but before gaining moksha, he has got these qualities of jiva. What are those? Bhayam and aramanam. That is how it is presented there. Anyway, he is the jiva. Now what he does is, he is a jiva, but he is a uskrushta jiva. He is not like a jiva like an ant or a human being. He is the jiva who is given birth to the entire human race. So, like even a person is there, you consider his great, great, great grandfather. You can say that so-called grandfather, can generations backwards, the grandfather, you can say he is the first person who is the father of all the clans. You can say that. For example, one gotra is there. What does it mean, the gotra? One particular rishi, he is the forefather of all these millions of people. So our Hiranyagarbha is like that. He is the first fellow who is the forefather of all the human race. Not only human race, all the entire living beings, he is the forefather. That is how Veda presents. It's a very logical presentation. So that gentleman, that Hiranyagarbha, he decided to have this jagat. So he expresses himself in the form of this jagat. How? He was the Virat. So what he does is, he makes himself into two. And then those two make themselves into four, like a cell division. So like meiosis or something they call it. So like that it goes on and on and on. Like that he makes all the jagat, containing all the jivas. And then he enters into the Hrudaya Guha of all these fellows. This is how it is presented. So that is referred here. That means it is as though all the ghatas are made and Akasha has entered into all the ghatas. The fact is, Akasha is there in the ghatas all the time. It has not entered now afresh. But then, why you say this Pravesha Shruti? Akasha has entered into the ghatas. Why you say that? Akashaha upalabhyate ghatasya antaha. That is the idea. So with reference to the upalabhyamanatvam, availability, the word Pravesha is used by the Shruti. That is what about Pravesha Shruti, etc. So the idea is the same Hiranyagarbha, who is the father of the entire universe of living beings, both of Stavara and Jangama, he has entered into the heart of every living being. It is like saying one rishi who is the pravartaka for the entire gotram, he is the forefather of the entire gotram, and now he is in the heart of the every person belonging to that gotram. That is the reason why the fellow says, Haritasa Gotraha. So I belong to that Gotra. That means that Harita, who is the Rishi, he is in my heart. He has entered my Guha. He is there. That's why I belong to that Gotra. Suppose there is no connection between Harita and this fellow, then why he should say Haritasa Gotraha, Sagotratvam, Samana Gotratvam? That why he should say that? He says that because it is understood that the Rishi is there in our heart. In the form of Chaitanya, he is also Chaitanya, I am also Chaitanya, so that Rishi is there. So this is the way in which Hiranyagarbha is presented. This Hiranyagarbha, that means what? So you are really Hiranyagarbha. Like you are really the forefather. Only Kala Bheda is there. Forefather has lived in one column, you are living in another column. The type of Kala Bhedam is there. Desha Bhedam is there, Vastu Bhedam is there, Body Bhedam is there. But then, the Atma which is the Shashvata Vastu, Desha Kala and Vastu are Mithya Bhuta, therefore with reference to the Atma you can say there is no Bhedam. Though with reference to Desha Kala Vastu there is a Bhedam. Therefore you look at the Atma, then you become one with the Hiranyagarbha. You can say with courage that my Atma and the Atma of the King is one and the same. My Atma and the Atma of the Hiranyagarbha, who is the forefather of the entire universe, is one and the same. So this truth who recognizes, he has known Atma. So, yaha tam prathamajam devadi shariran yutpadya. So that prathamaja is there. He has created all these living beings, starting from devatas up to a blade of grass. So all these Shrirani Upadhyā, having done that, what the Hiranyagarbha has done, Sarva Prani Guham Pravishya, Guham Pravishya Tishthantam, that is the mantra.
So he has entered into Sarva Prani Guha. How he could enter into all the pranis? How Akasha is entering into all the ghatas? Same way. That means there is no entry like a creature entering into a hole. That type of entry, it is not there. It is availability is jatha. So we say Akasha has entered into all ghatas. We mean Akasha is available in all the ghatas. Similarly, then we say Hiranyagarbha has entered into all the living beings, sarva prani guham, so hrudaya akasham pravishya tishthantam. He is there inside every prani guha, means you are really the Hiranyagarbha. With reference to the jiva limitation, you are not a jiva restricted to this body, you are really the Hiranyagarbha. Only difference between you and the Hiranyagarbha is you are at the level of macrocosm, microcosm. Hiranyagarbha is at the level of macrocosm. That is the only difference. Otherwise, absolutely there is no difference. This upadhi bheda, if you can overlook with the knowledge of Atma, then you are the Hiranyagarbha. So that truth, so Hiranyagarbha is in my heart. This is an upasana also. Hrudayakasham pravishya tishthantam Hiranyagarbham. And he is pravishya tishthantam means he is there means what? He is the real bhokta, shabdadin upalabhamanam. So now instead of saying Parameshwara Shuddha Chaitanya is the bhokta, now we are saying Hiranyagarbha is the bhokta. Jiva is the bhokta. So the same Atma with different perspective, with different standpoint is presented like that. So that Hiranyagarbha is the one who is really the enjoyer of Shabdadi, this Vishayas. That upalabhamanam. Bhute bhihi bhutaihi karyakarana lakshanai sahatishthantam. He is there in the Hrudaya Guha together with Bhuta. So, then I am, as a jiva, I am here in the Hrudaya Guha. I am there by keeping all the Pancha Bhutas in place. I am the Dharakaha. I keep them in place. I keep the assembly intact and keep it going. So that is the job I am doing. So that is the Hiranyagarbha also. That is the same job is done by Hiranyagarbha. Because this jiva is in reality Hiranyagarbha alone. So bhutebhihi means bhutaihi, means karyakarana lakshanaihi. So karyakarana lakshanaihi means, so this bijam of the body, that is the karanam, and it has manifested into the form of various majja, mamsa, etc., karya, then that is one way. Or karana means karana. Karya is the deham. Karana is karana indriya. So that is how karya karana kartrutve, kartrutve, that Gita shloka, there karana is understood as, is defined as karana, with the indriyam. So along with indriyas, under this majja mamsadi sthula deha, along with that, Hiranyagarbha is residing in the heart, while all the time enjoying shabda, rupa, rasa, etc., which are outside to the body. So sahatishthantam, this truth who has recognized, yaha vyapashyata, yaha sadhakaha recognized. Vyapashyata means yaha pashyati yetat. So this type of upasana one who does, this is Hiranyagarbha upasana. Or this truth also, with reference to upadhi negation, you can see the same Atma, the Jivatma, and also Hiranyagarbha Atma. Next. Ya evam pashyati, sa etadeva pashyati, yattat prakrutam brahma. So a person who is doing this type of Hiranyagarbha upasana, or this type of Hiranyagarbha jnanam, Hiranyagarbha darshanam it is called. A person who is doing that, he is indeed doing a, not a different darshanam. He is indeed doing the darshanam of the same Atma. It is not different at all. So, etadeva pashyati. Etat means what? Etatat prakrutam brahma. That is the subject matter of our discussion. That brahma, prakrutam is the subject matter of context. That brahma alone he is seeing. Hiranyagarbha is not different from the Brahma. For example, you see the kundalam. So So you are seeing the kundalam means you are seeing something different from gold. No, kundalam drishyate means kundalasya karanam svarnameva drishyate. Similarly, hiranyagarbham pashyati means hiranyagarbhasya karanam brahmanameva, brahma eva pashyati chakra. Kincha ya pranena sambhavati adityar devatamayi guham pravishyati sthantim ya bhute virvyajayata etadvai tat ya pranena sambhavati adityar devatamayi गुहां प्रविश्यतिष्ठन्तीं या भूते भिर्व्यजायत सी हिरण्यगर्भ इज प्रेजेंटेड एज ए कंबाइंड एस्पेक्ट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ ज्ञानशक्ति एंड क्रियाशक्ति समटाइम्स इफ यू ट्राई टू डिफाइन द टू शक्तीज सेपरेटली then Hiranyagarbha represents the Jnana Shakti and the Kriya Shakti is represented by another tattva. Hiranyagarbha is a mahat, that the samashti buddhyatmaka mahatattva is there. So mahatattva abhimani Hiranyagarbha, the other day I was telling you, that mahatattva abhimani is the Hiranyagarbha. So here the type of distinction is being made. Hiranyagarbha means mahatattva abhimani jathaha. That's why buddhya-svarupaha, that's why he is hrudaya-guhayam tishthan, he is enjoying the buddhi-indriya svikruta roparasadhi. So it is the buddhi, jnanendriya. Jnanendriya's duty to see rupam, to enjoy rupam, rasam, etc. So this Hiranyagarbha, who is the abhimani of that mahatattvam, he is the one who is enjoying all this rupa, rasa, etc. That makes it pakka that in that context, Hiranyagarbha means jnana shakti pradhanaha, mahatattva abhimani. Then we have another aspect of the Bhagavan, that is kriya shakti. That is there in the body. We have jnana shakti and kriya shakti. Jnana shakti is at the base of all the jnanendriyas. Kriya shakti is at the base of all the karmendriyas. So we have an intellect, we have uchvasa nishvasa, we have buddhi, at the same time we have metabolism going on in the process. Both are there. We have a mind which thinks and we have a mind which controls all the indriyas, legs, hands, etc. So what happened? So mind is now two aspects. So the one aspect is jnana shakti, the other aspect is kriya shakti. At the samashti level, at the cosmic level, this jnana shakti is Hiranyagarbha. Then that kriya shakti has got a name. That is Adityhi. Not only that, it is the jnana shakti marries the kriya shakti. Maithunam is Mithuna coming together because a family, a house is made up of by two fellows, wife and husband. Suppose the wife and husband quarrel, then house will be okay, walls and everything will be okay, air conditioners, everything are okay, but the house loses its significance. There is no more house there. There is no home anymore. So only walls, etc. are there. That combination of the, that coming together of the hearts is very essential. What I mean is, this Hiranyagarbha, he has got another name. His name is Kashyapa. I have heard this name, Kashyapa Prajapati. You know why he is called Kashyapa? Kashyapa Pashyapo Bhavati Tat Sarvam Paripashyati Ti Saukshmyat. That is the Veda Mantra. So Kashyapa is nothing but Pashyakaha. Pashyati Ti Pashyakaha. He sees. How he sees? Sarvam Paripashyati. He sees everything in a very deep way, not a superficial seeing. Paritaha Pashyati, he sees it in its totality. So saukshmyata, this type of sukshma darshana shakti, that is what is called buddhi. That sukshma buddhi he has got. That is what means, he is the buddhi shakti pradhanaha, he is the jnana shakti pradhanaha. Therefore that Hiranyagarbha Now got another name. Is a yogikan name. Yogika name in the sense by the characteristic of being an abhimani for the buddhi is called pashyakaha. Pashyatiti pashyakaha. In Veda, the word vyatyaya takes place. Kashyapa. Pashyakaha is converted to kashyapaha. Why to convert? Why keep it only pashyakaha? This Vedam has a characteristic. It hides. Suppose you give a presentation to somebody. You hide it in a package and give it to him. He has to wait for a few hours before really knowing what is inside. So something like that. So Veda also puts it as kashyapaha. So unless somebody comes and tells you it is none other than Hiranyagarbha, till then you won't know it. This is the way in which Shruti proceeds. So they say, Parokshapriya Ivahi Devaha Prachakshadvishaha. That is also there. This is another mantra in Taittiriya. So Devaha, that is Hiranyagarbhadi Devaha, they are Parokshapriya. They maintain Parokshapriyatvam. This is there in Aitreya Upanishad also. So they hide the things a little. Don't open it everything, keep a thing a little hide. So prachakshat vishaha, you should not expose everything outside. You have to keep things hidden. That is the way in which Shruti proceeds. So to hide this fact, prachakaha is converted to kashyapaha. So he is a prajapati. In this story you have seen who is the wife of Kashyapa Prajapati? Aditi. Aditi is the wife of Kashyapa Prajapati. So we have come to that Aditi. So Kashyapa Prajapati is the buddhi shakti, jnana shakti pradhanaha. And that is the Aditi is kriya shakti pradhanaha. So then the combination makes a family. From that family, a host of devatas are born. So that is the Aditi. That kriya shakti pradhana Aditi is the Deva Mata. She is the mother of whom? Gadesha Adityas. Aditi, Aditeha Patyam is Adityaha. Vamanaha is the son of Aditi. That Vamana Avatara. Parameshwara Vishnu has come, become as the son of Aditi. She is the mother, and she is the mother of Indra. So she is the mother of all these devatas. That means what? Kriya Shakti Pradhana Devata. So Kriya Shakti ka Adhishthan Devata. That is the Aditi. That Aditi is not different from Atma. That is the mantra. So that is how it is present. So Veda in Samhita, this Aditi is presented in a big way. And when it comes to Upanishad, the same Aditi is merged with Atma. So in Samhita we have the mantra, Aditriya Pranena Saha Sambhavati Sarvarupa. This sir, this Aditi is everything. Sarva Rupa, all these pranis are there. The entire universe is a manifestation of the Kriya Shakti alone. Every atom is in flux. It is continuously moving. Where from this energy has come? The entire universe is dynamic. There is nothing static in this universe. So all the atoms, subatomic particles, they are all moving with terrific speed. And then when you come to the other side of the spectrum, namely the galaxies, etc., they are all moving with terrific speed. There is nothing static in this universe. The earth is constantly moving around the sun. The sun is going away somewhere in the galaxy called Milky Way galaxy. And the entire Milky Way galaxy is receding from us at a terrific speed. It's an unimaginable astronomical picture. So this Kriya Shakti is there, entire universe is there. It is there in this body, the Kriya Shakti of this body. My God, it's a big, big, big science. So that Kriya Shakti is the Aditi. And Aditi hi, ya pranayana saha sambhavati sarvarupena. That's why there is another mantra in Taittiriya, Aditir yaur aditir antariksham aditir mata sapita. These are the way in which Aditi is described. So, in Chandigya it comes, kapita, pranapita, ko mata, prano mata, like that it is presented. It is the prana. You see, prana means there is a person. His father is another person. There is a prana shakti in the father, therefore he could give birth to a child. Or the mother has got prana shakti, she could give birth to the child. Now child is a different from pranashakti. What is a child? A panchabhutatmaka deha is not the child. The pranashakti which is there very much entirely throughout the body, that is the child. So the father, who is the father? Is not a body, is the father. The pranashakti is the father. The pranashakti is the child. So Aditir Mata, Aditir Pita, Aditir Yohu, Aditir Antariksham, because everywhere you have all the galaxies and everything moving. So this Kriya Shakti is the Aditihi. So Sapita, Saputraha, so father, son, etc. of the Vishve Deva, Aditir Panchajana, all the devatas are Aditi. Because devatas are Kriya Shakti, therefore they are Aditi. Panchajanaha means all the human beings are Aditi. Human beings are called panchajana. Why you know? Panchabhutebhyaha nirmita itartha. So these fellows, everybody is made up of panchabhutas only. There is even Clinton, he is also made up of panchabhutas. There is no difference. That's why these fellows are called panchajana. All these panchajanas, they are all the children of Aditi. Aditir jatam, Aditir janitvam. Jatam, what is all born earlier, that is Aditi. Janitvam, the property of getting birth and that the progeny, etc., continuing, the future, it is all Aditi. This Aditi is a very big thing. So it is described like that in the Karmakanda. So in Karmakanda, Aditi becomes one of the most important devatas. There are oblations for Aditi, there is upasana for Aditi, everything is there. But when you come here, the Shruti says, because it was presenting the same Aditi in a very big way earlier. Now Shruti says that Aditi, sir, which I was teaching you earlier, that Aditi is Atma alone. That is the way it needs to be presented. So ya pranena sambhavate Adithihi devatamayi. So all the mantras I told you, which entirely explain every word in that mantram. So guham pravishyati shthantim. Not only buddhi shakti is there in the guha, Aditi is also there in the guha. Heart has got a vivaram, a chidram, in which Parameshwara is present. That is what we say. So that is what Shruti says. Similarly, heart is moving also. That movement of the heart is Aditi. Therefore, that Akasha is inside there. Akasha is there means a movement is also there. Therefore, that movement corresponds to this Aditi. So she is there in the guha. She is there or alone or what? No, bhute bhihi. Together with the pancha bhutas, she is there. And that aditi etatvai, that is the idea. Bhashya. Ya sarvadevata mayi sarvadevata atmika. That mayat is not prachurya marani sachkin. Mayat swaruparthe mayat. So sarvadevata mayi means sarvadevata swarupini vityarthaha. Pranena, Hiranyagarbharupena. So Aditi is the Kriya Shakti, together with Hiranyagarbha, she is there in this body. So Parasmat Brahmanasambhavati. Prana is the name given to Hiranyagarbha. So is the Buddhi Shakti Pradhanaha. Aditi is the Kriya Shakti Pradhanaha. Both of them are born from the same Parameshwara. Earlier we have seen in one mantra, Bodha Bodha Rupaha Hiranyagarbha. So the same, there both are merged together and made into one Hiranyagarbha. You can say that I have a Buddhi Shakti, I have a Kriya Shakti. You can present it in two ways, or you can merge both and say I have Shakti. So if you say that way, this way, both ways you can understand it. So Shruti speaks this way as well as that way. There Bodha Bodhatmakaha Shankaracharya told there, Bhashyakara. Because the same Hiranyagarbha is now going to be divided later into two parts. That's why there he has mentioned casually, Bodha Bodhatmakaha, both Bodha and Abodha put together is that Hiranyagarbha. Here Bodha is separated, Abodha is separated. Shabdadinam Adanat Adithihi. That is the meaning of Aditi. Why she is Aditi? Shabdadinam adanat. You see, the Shrotrendriya is there. In fact, the Prana Devata, she is the main force behind the functions of all the Indriyas. Shrotrendriya is able to work. then because of the Aditi, because of the Prana Devata is there. In Chandogya, a story is there. In the beginning, Udgita Vidya itself, this story comes. So these Indriyas, they fight among themselves. Vagindriya says, I am the great. Shrotriyendriya says, no, you are not the great, I am the great. Netriyendriya says, Sarvendriyanam Nayanam Pradhanam, I am the great. Like that, all these Indriyas fight. Prana keeps going. Prana doesn't say anything. These Indriyas, they go to the Prana Devata. Oh, Devata, please settle who are the best among us. Then the Prana Devata says, I will come after 1 minute and then I will give you my judgment. Then Prana Devata rises. She wants to go. When Prana Devata rises, all the Indriyas are dead. They are about to die. They cannot withstand that Prana Devata is going away. Then they say to Prana Devata, oh Prana Devata, don't go away, be here. Then Prana Devata stays. Then all the Indriyas say, we are not the great, you are the great. This is the story. So that story indicates that the Prana Deva, this Aditi, is the Sarvendriya Shakti is coming from Adithihi. So that's why Bhashyakara says, Shabdadinam Adanat Adithihi. So this Shakti gives the functions of all the Indriyas are coming from that Shakti alone. Sve Adithihi, Adanat Adithihi. There is another Niruktacharya given meaning for Adithihi. Adina Adithihi. So she doesn't know what is Dainyam. Dainyam is what? So the fellow has got Dainyam, it means he is not in a position to do any work. That is the Dainyam. Dhyanaha Kinchidati Kartum Na Shiknoti. What he can do? Dhyanatva. So he is a depressed fellow. Dhyana is depressed. He will not be able to walk even properly. That is the Dhyanatvam. The Dhyanatvam is not there in Aditi. In Kriyashakti, where is the Dhyanatvam? Therefore, Aditi is Adina, and she is the mother of all devatas. Each devata is an Indriya, is a devata. That is the Devata Mata means all the Indriyas are called devatas in their own sphere because Jnana Swarupa. I is a Jnana Swarupini, therefore it's a devata. All devatas are born from the Prana Devata, therefore that is Aditi. So devatas are born from Aditi. This is all Pauranika language. So that Aditi, next, Purvavate Guham Pravishyatishthantim. So she is there in the Guha. Like even Hiranyagarbha Buddhishakti is there in the Guha, this Aditi is also there in the Guha. So Tameva Vishinashti Ya Bhute Bhihi Bhotai Samanvita Vyajayata Utpanne Chetat. So that Aditi is born from the same Brahma by tapas etc. So that Aditi etat by tat. It is Atma Indra. Here Anandagiri says Hiranyagarbhasyaiva prakarantaramaha. That is what he says. He says, Aditi, we are just dividing Kriya Shakti as though it is separate from Hiranyagarbha. This is Hiranyagarbha alone. In fact, that Brahadaranyaka Brahmanam, there Hiranyagarbha becomes two. One is Bodha Shakti, another is Kriya Shakti. So finally what happens is, this one only. You can look at both ways. But anyway, that is how Shruti has presented. Kincha Aranyor nihito jata vedaha garbha iva subhruto garbhini vihi dive diva idyaha jagru vadbhir havishmadbhihi manushye bhiragnihi etad vaitat. So we started with Brahma, and that Brahma gave birth to Hiranyagarbha, etadvaitata, Aditi, etadvaitata. Now come to Karmakanda. Karmakanda, there is Agni. Upasana, there is Agni. We have seen Nachiketa Agni consists of both aspects. Agni, Upasya Agni, and Chetavya Agni. That means Anushthiyamana Agni. That Agni, what about it? That Agni also is Brahma only. It is not different from Brahma. this Pratyagatma is Brahma, Hiranyagarbha is Brahma, Agni is also Brahma. That means you can see Brahma in the Agni. The truth of Agni is the Brahma. So that is presented in this mantra. This Agni is a big thing. This is the basis of the entire Karma Kanda. And this is also the basis of the entire Upasana Kanda. Therefore, Shruti is describing this Agni with a little more interest. This Agni is compared in two ways. One is a Bahiranga Drishtantam, another is an Antaranga Drishtanta. Bahiranga Drishtanta is Aranyornihito Jata Vedaha. So Jata Vedaha is Agni. So, because of him, the Vedas have got their existence. Veda is all about Agni. Agnimide Purohitam. So Veda is pronounced, means Agni is there already. Rigveda is the main Veda, which is the first Veda in the Veda Kramam. And the Rigveda starts with Agni. Therefore, Vedena Saha Jataha, Jata Vedaha. So, he is the one from whom the Veda is born, or he is the basis for the entire knowledge of Veda, the Jata Veda. Where is he? Aranyor Nihita. Arani means a wooden slab. So there are two aspects of the Arani. Which is a wooden slab is called Adhararani. And there is a post, a wooden post, which is just rubbed to that wooden slab. So during the process of that rubbing, you must have seen when this Agnihotra is done. During the process of rubbing, Agni is born. So that is Uttararani. This post which is used to rub, it is Uttararani, Adhararani. Dvivachanam. Aranyo. In between the Aranis, Agni is there. Now Agni, suppose it is not there, then by rubbing where from it will come? It is there. Therefore by rubbing it will come. Aranyor Nihitaha Jata Vedaha. There is Agni. But unless Sukshma Buddhi is there, you cannot recognize the existence of Jata Veda. Therefore, a jnani or a person who knows the truth of Atma, he says, or who can see in a with a Sukshma Buddhi, he says this Arani is Uttararani and Adhararani, though Agni doesn't appear to be there in them as of now. In reality, Agni is there. So this is what is the Sukshma Buddhi. Suppose the fellow has no Sukshma Buddhi. He says, Parvata Vanniman Dhumat, he says. But then there is no Dhuma here. Aranis are there. Therefore Agni is not there for him. That is what is called Sthola Buddhi. So a person with Sukshma Buddhi alone will be able to see this Agni. And then I told you Agni of three kinds. There is a second kind of Agni, Upasya Agni. So what happens is, the manas is the adhararani, and the sadhana, the mantram, upasana.